World, it's Rahul. Welcome back guys to Deep Learning Tutorial. As we have discussed about how neural network works, you are probably thinking that deep neural network is really great. But why did it take so long to come into picture? Well, if I go back to 80s or 90s, at that time when researchers tried to train a deep neural network with a method called backpropagation, they ran into a fundamental problem called vanishing gradient or sometimes the exploding gradient. Because we had to only use sigmoid function in each and every neuron we were using, because at that time ReLU activation function was not discovered. So guys, let's try to understand what is vanishing gradient and exploding gradient. How does this problem occur and what methods are basically used to overcome these problems? So when we train a neural network, we are constantly calculating a cost value, where cost is typically difference between the predicted value and the actual value. Then the cost is lowered by making slight adjustments to weights and biases over and over throughout the training process until the lowest possible value. Guys, let's take a very simple neural network structure where I'm having three input features in input layer. Then we have hidden layer with two neurons and then output layer. Now, here what this particular neural network will do is basically take the summation of input features, multiply by weights, and then addition of bias. And then we apply activation function before passing it to next layer. And when I say activation function, so here I am only considering sigmoid activation function. As I have told you that we were not having any other activation function during the time of 80s or 90s. So guys, I've already uploaded a video on different type of activation function where I've explained about sigmoid activation function that basically describes that how sigmoid activation function transforms the summation of input features multiplied by weights and addition of bias term between 0 and 1. So at each neuron, same activation function is applied and it is transforming the output between 0 and 1. And finally, we get the output. So here we get output as y hat. Now we have to compare the predicted output with actual output for being double sure whether our model is predicting the correct output or not. And for doing so, we calculate the loss function where we are actually taking difference between y hat and actual y value. So guys, here we create an optimizer which will reduce this loss function so that we can reach to the global minima, or in simpler words, which will match our predicted value with actual value. So now our only target is to reduce this loss function. But here question is, how can we reduce this loss function? So by updating the weights and backpropagate this to neural network, we can reduce the loss function. So guys, if you don't know about backpropagation, then I will suggest you to pause this video and watch my video on backpropagation. I've shared the link into description. So when we backpropagate the loss function, we basically update the weights, and here weight updation formula is W new is equal to W old minus learning rate multiplied by derivative of loss function with respect to all the weights. So guys, now our focus will only be at this, which is nothing but the derivative of loss function, and we will see how is this creating the vanishing gradient problem. So guys, here our output is E, which we are considering as error. Now let's see which all values are affecting this output. So here output E is getting impacted by output 1 and output 1 is impacted by weight 1. So if you can see, we are basically using chain rule over here, and same I have told you guys in backpropagation video. So for finding out the derivation of loss function with respect to weight W1, what we have to do is we have to find the derivative of E with respect to output W1. As we have just seen now, that output E is directly getting impacted from output 1. Now, we multiply this by derivative of output 1 with respect to weight 1, as output 1 is directly impacted by weight W1. So guys, since we are using sigmoid activation function over here, let me tell you that sigmoid function ranges between 0 and 1. And derivative of sigmoid activation function ranges between 0 to 0.25. Let's quickly see how derivative of sigmoid ranges between 0 to 0.25. Because understanding this is very important, as we will see how is this vanishing gradient problem going to happen? So guys, we know that for sigmoid activation function, our value ranges between 0 to 1 and graph looks like as shown on the screen. Now let's see how is this range get transformed when we take derivative of sigmoid function. So formula for sigmoid activation function is 1 over 1 plus e to the power minus x. Now let's take the derivative of this term. So derivative of 1 over 1 plus e to the power minus x divided by derivative of x. Guys, let's take 1 plus e to the power minus x in numerator. So this complete term will get raised by a power of minus 1. So if you know little bit about how to find the derivative, then first we find derivative for power term and then remaining term. So we will take minus 1 in front of value and subtract the power by minus 1. Now we have to take derivative of 1 plus e to the power minus x. Here we are having two terms. So by applying rule of linearity, let's take derivative of both terms separately. So derivative of 1 with respect to x and derivative of e to the power minus x with respect to x. Okay, that was simple. Now let's derive each of them one by one. Now derivative of a constant is 0, and by applying exponential rule, we will find derivative of e raised to power minus x, which will be e raised to power minus x as it is. But we have to find derivative of power term, that is minus x, and this would be minus 1. So here we have find out the derivative of complete term. Now let's solve this particular equation as shown on the screen. So guys, let's move 1 plus e to the power minus x whole square to denominator, as its power is having negative sign, which will become positive in denominator. So guys, we can write this equation as shown on the screen, where we are just taking dot products of 1 plus e to the power minus x, which will make square of this. And since plus 1 minus 1 is equal to 0, we can do this as well. Now let's break the fraction and rewrite it. Let's cancel out the numerator and denominator. So by considering 1 over 1 plus e to the power minus x as sigmoid of x, we can rewrite this as sigmoid of x multiplied by 1 minus sigmoid of x. So this is the formula for derivative of sigmoid. Now if you will put the x value as 0, then derivative of sigmoid will be 0.25. So graph for this will be something like shown on the screen. Guys, this is very important to understand, as you will hardly get the solution for this. So now let's again consider the derivative of loss function with respect to weight. Let's say for this I am taking derivative as 0.16 and for this I am taking derivative value as 0.01. Guys, one thing to note here is that derivative range will be 0 to 0.25 only. So when we multiply 0.16 with 0.1, then I will get somewhere around 0.016. So now derivative of loss function with respect to weight is 0.016. Now let's apply this into weight updation formula. Now let's say our W old value is 3.8 and learning rate as 1 for ease of our calculation. So 3.8 minus 1 into 0.016, which is equal to 3.784. And this is only just for 2-layer network. But if I go for deep neural network and increase the layers, then my derivative value will go on decreasing as number of layer increase. Let's say for 4-layer neural network, we have derivative of first term is somewhere around 2.3. Then derivative of second term is 0.9. Then derivative of third term is 0.07. And derivative of last term is 0.008. And if we multiply all this, then you only think that how small our value will become. And if we apply this into weight updation formula, then our W new and W old will almost become equivalent. That's why sigmoid activation function should not be used in each and every layer. So here our gradient value is decreasing, and at certain epoch it decays completely and loses the path without reaching at global minima. So guys, this is how vanishing gradient occurs in deep neural network, where we are using sigmoid activation function and our W old value is almost equal to W new value. Therefore, we are not updating anything during the model training and just activating the neuron without actually providing any information to model, which works as a dead neuron, which is of no use for machine learning model. So guys, we can solve this problem by making use of ReLU activation function. So if you have watched my video on activation function, then probably you will understand how can we overcome this problem of vanishing gradient. But if you haven't watched it yet, then please go and watch ReLU activation. Now let's understand the exploding gradient problem. So here also, our focus will only be on derivative of loss function with respect to weight for updating the weights. So by using a chain rule, I can write this. We have already seen this earlier. So now, if I want to find the derivative of this weight term, then I basically need to find out the derivative of all these values. So my chain rule will be derivative of loss function with respect to weight equal to derivative of output O3 divided by derivative of output O2 multiplied by derivative of output O2 divided by derivative of output O1 multiplied by derivative of output O1 divided by derivative of weight W1. Now let's understand how is this exploding gradient problem is actually happening. So let's consider this particular derivative. Now, what will be the derivative of output O2 with respect to output O1? So here O2 is nothing but the multiplication of output O1 and W1 plus bias term. And this will be passed to activation function. So I can directly write it as activation of Z. And here Z is multiplication of output O1 and W1 plus bias term. So here I can write it as derivative of activation of Z divided by derivative of Z multiplied by derivative of Z divided by derivative of output O1. So here we are using sigmoid activation function. So here my first derivative value will range between 0 to 0.25. As I have already explained you that sigmoid activation function ranges between 0 to 0.25. And for second term, let's put the Z value and find out the derivative of this. And if I derivate this with respect to Z, then I will get just weight W term. So exploding gradient is totally dependent on weight. Let me tell you how. So let's consider the first term as 0.21 and second term as 120, which is nothing but the weight. And when I multiply this, it will become 25.2. Now let's say for this, my value is 25.2. And for this, I calculated as 12, considering my weights are higher. So it will become larger value with increase the number of layers. So once we have this value, we can replace this in weight updation formula. And this will make a very small value once we will subtract this from old weight. So it will never converge, instead jump here and there, but not reach at global minima. So guys, understanding this is very important, that how the weights can be initialized. Because if weight initialization is not correct, then it will never converge the model and creates exploding gradient problem considering any of the activation function. So guys, you need not to worry. I'll upload a video on weight initialization separately. So guys, this is all about vanishing gradient and exploding gradient problem. Like what is vanishing and exploding gradient problem? How does this occur? And how can we overcome these problems? Hope you understand each segment of this video. Thank you guys for your time. Do like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Happy learning and stay safe.